Welcome to Integrating Smarter Balance and NGSS Interim Assessments into Practice. This video will provide you with detailed ideas on how to integrate the math, ELA, and science interim assessment blocks or individual items into your practice beyond giving them simply as formal assessments. The Smarter Balance Interim Assessments and the tools that support the interim, such as the Assessment Viewing Application, or AVA, tools for teachers, and the Centralized Reporting System, or CRS, can support teachers in their professional development and pre-teaching activities, lessons, formative or interim assessment goals, and post-teaching follow-up. The Centralized Reporting System houses more than the scores on an interim assessment block. All item metadata is available, student responses to each item, answer keys, and supporting materials for the math and ELA blocks are available as well. The Interim Assessment Item Portal and Tools for Teachers also houses this metadata, which can be easily saved or downloaded. The CRS provides users with the scores on a block, but also breaks down the items on which students performed the best and the worst. Using this feature in the system, teachers can analyze student responses to determine next steps for instruction. You may be asking yourself, now what? What should I concentrate on when looking at information in the centralized reporting system? We'd like to encourage you to look past the category labels and really dig into the items themselves. Here are some questions that could be asked. Were there items that all your students struggled with? Were there items that all your students did well on? Are there any patterns in the way they responded? Were there outliers, items that all but a few students did well on? What instruction would benefit those few students? Were there trends in answers based on particular types of items? Does it look like students know what to do with technology-enhanced items like graphing or tables? How are they handling the multi-select items, which allow them to choose more than one correct answer? What did you notice while reviewing any constructed responses? Using the list of items on which students performed the worst, read the item and think about what the item's measuring. Using the available metadata, see how difficult the item is. And lastly, determine what content a student might need to know in order to answer a question. For some, AVA may be one of the first resources to access when determining the appropriateness or relevance of an interim assessment block in relation to a unit that a teacher is incorporating in class. Use the Assessment Viewing Application to preview blocks and the content they're measuring. After administering a block and reviewing data results, teachers might use AVA to review items on which students struggled. Teachers can also use an item to demonstrate a skill they're teaching. The item can be shown to all students, and the teacher can model how an introduction might be written, how a paragraph would be edited, a problem solved, or a science topic approached. These items can also be a valuable part of professional development. Teachers might work through difficult items and incorporate them into their PD to prepare for the assessments, to better understand the expectations, or to see how their curriculum aligns to what's being measured. The Connecticut Core Standards note that the standards leave room for educators to determine the full range of metacognitive strategies that benefit students. I suggest using the interims to support the teaching of skills such as note-taking, a skill that's a critical part of the learning process that helps keep students alert and engaged, supports memory and recall, and provides a record of important information. Using AVA, teachers can choose an appropriate prompt aligned to a subject area or lesson from the informational stimuli to teach note-taking skills. These stimuli were chosen only after we determined that they were grade appropriate complex text. The listening stimuli, also deemed grade appropriate and complex, can be used to teach or reinforce note-taking skills as well. Many of the stimuli cross content areas such as science, social studies, history, or geography. Short discussions concerning test-taking might include asking students why they chose the answer they chose or if they even read the item stem closely. Many students don't take the time to review their responses before moving to the next item or submitting a test. Getting students into the habit of carefully reading the actual question and briefly reviewing their responses prior to moving on to the next item or submitting tests can improve overall performance. When reviewing students' responses to items, sometimes wrong answers provide the most valuable information. Focusing on the choices of wrong answers might let you know where your students have been misinformed or in those areas they struggle. The centralized reporting system's toggle feature allows the user to choose an item and toggle through all the individual responses provided by every student who was administered the block in the same session. Another way to use AVA is to pre-screen an interim block, for example, in mathematics. You could choose a couple of items to use as a pretest before instructing students on a concept. An example might be the underlying concept with regard to the algebraic rules governing the order of operations. Before instructions, you can direct the student to complete two items. The item might ask the student to correctly interpret a mathematical expression. In the second test, selected items are similar in concept to the first set used as a pretest. You might choose to have that same concept asked in two different ways. In other words, the expectation of a standard, as interpreted by Smarter Balance, will require the student to move in either direction, text to expression or expression to text. Both of these pathways, though, are driving at the same mathematical understanding. Giving this variety in the pretest and also in the post-test is a good idea. What you would look for is which students can respond correctly to the items given after instruction and which may still be having trouble. As a reminder, items on the interim blocks come from the same item pool that was used to create the end-of-year summative assessments, so they are the same style and difficulty of the items on that test. The stimuli also contain rich Tier 2 and 3 vocabulary. There are two documents that contain content-relevant vocabulary lists, one for math and one for ELA. These are lists of out-of-grade level vocabulary, which are still considered necessary to students because they relate to valuable content required by the standards. At each grade level, teachers should integrate these words into their discussions and assignments to familiarize students with them. The NGSS item specifications include lists of acceptable vocabulary terms that students should be familiar with for each performance expectation. These terms may appear in the assessment items without further explanation. Lastly, students should be taught short lessons on test-taking skills and study skills, and these can be taught using the items and stimuli from the interims. Since the texts in the blocks represent the difficulty level of the type of text students should be using in the classroom, they can easily be used to teach annotating. Teaching students to annotate text will help them learn to look quickly for important information and to identify areas of difficulty they may be having. These skills are valuable across content areas. Using the pre-selected stimuli from the interims, teachers can model annotating skills for students. The audio clips on the interim assessments are brief, less than 60 seconds. We love the idea of maximizing access to content on a potentially interesting and educational topic and embedding other resources across media to support the students. This is what we came up with. Using the audio stimuli available on AVA, identify a relevant audio topic to present to your class. Present the listening audio and facilitate conversations or activities from that short piece. Then branch out, having students research the topic they find interesting or extending the information in a short listening stimulus. Use the item stems without the multiple choice items as discussion starters. By accessing the items and stimuli from a listening block through the Interim Item Assessment Portal and Tools for Teachers, you can get a PDF of the listening stimuli, and that can be used for students who may need a transcript of the stimulus. The literary informational stimuli can be used as a mini lesson or mini check when teaching a specific skill. For example, these blocks can be great tools when used to model how to analyze within and across text and to use text evidence to support important inferences and conclusions. Teachers can use stimuli to teach skills beyond those measured by the block. For example, teachers could use think alouds to expand inferences related to author's purpose, use of language, and text structure, among other important literary traits that impact meaning and student understanding. The brief writes are an amazing support to the teaching of writing. Using AVA, display an item and model the desired skill. Do this as a think aloud, so students understand the metacognitive strategies employed when writing. Also, by extending the focus to include more than what a particular item measures, I can teach multiple writing strategies with one stimuli. For example, the item asks students to write an ending to a story. Now, ask students to elaborate on the existing stimuli by incorporating dialogue or details that further develop the characters or the plot. Do this as a whole group or small group activity. During the small group activity, you might have groups share their quote-unquote new and improved story with the rest of the class. Another available tool in the Connecticut portal under the Smarter Balance tab are the practice and training tests. The purpose of training tests is to become familiar with the system, functionality, and item types. These tests are not intended to guide classroom instruction. They contain, on average, less than 10 items. Practice tests are a little longer and include items from all measured claims. These practice sessions again, give students the opportunity to familiarize themselves with a variety of item types, the universal tools available, and some of the designated tools. Students can browse the grade level assessments to introduce them to the content in a stress-free situation. Responses to the practice and training tests are not recorded. Once the student submits their test, it's erased. Teachers can provide short demonstrations, if necessary, on how to respond to an item type or a particularly difficult or complex item. For example, the math assessment offers an embedded Desmos calculator for calculator-allowed items in grades 6 through 8 and 11. Teachers can show students how to use this online tool so that they develop user competencies with ease. For students using English Learner Supports, a review of the translation glossary on the math interims may be useful. For more information on the interim assessments, visit our CSDE interim assessment webpage or contact a consultant to answer any of your questions.